Okay, so this is a video to help you write a program that'll display the numbers 0 through 10 in the first column, and then the square roots of the numbers in the second column. So we're gonna follow this idea of top-down design. So really the most important thing that we have in this program is our input and output, and then also our loop. So let's think about how we would build that in. Really, our only output is to tell the user what the program's doing. So let's start off with this. So this program will numbers 0 through 10 and the square roots. Now our next step would be to maybe create a data table. So let's start off and say here's our number, and let's give it some spaces, and then here is our square root. All right, so it looks like we got the majority of our input output. The numbers here are actually going to be details that we'll add in a little later. And let's think about the next major part of our program, which would be a loop. Why don't we use a for loop? Because we know exactly how many times we want to go through this loop. So it'd be for open parentheses, define a counter, so int I. We'll put a 0 in there, so you could either do equals 0 or put the 0 in parentheses. For loop again has those semicolons in there, and so we'll do I. Now you could do I less than 11 or I less than or equal to 10. Let's do less than or equal to 10 just so we have a slightly different example. And then each time we execute this loop, we want I to increase by 1. So notice the semicolons after your initialization, and then the semicolon after the test. And then press enter with your for loop and then do an open brace. Most of the IDEs will automatically populate a close brace for you. Now, let's not get into the guts of the program. Let's just get the flow working. So the way we could check to see if the flow is working is we could just print out I. And we don't want the i's to be right on top of each other, so let's do an inline. Let's see if we can just get that for loop working and see if we can get those i's working. Okay, fantastic. We've got our number. So now let's see if we can get the square root part of it working. So we'll use a square root function and we'll put our I in there. Now, without any spacing, those two things are going to just be right jam on top of each other. Let's put in a backslash T. That'll be a tab spacing in between I and the square root. Okay, we've got an error here, so let's see what our error is. SQRT is not a member of STD. Okay, so SQRT is a math function. Let's see if we include CMath, if that'll fix it. Okay, now we got our numbers printing out, and we got our square roots printing out. So everything's looking pretty good. We just need to format the output. Looks like I added way too many spaces. So when you format the output, think about it starting from the top and kind of going down. So this is going to determine the spacing here. So let's get this reasonable first. Okay, that's much better. We're going to need to use some input-output manipulators. So let's include IO manip. And let's start with just a column spacing here. So we'll do a set W. Let's see, number has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces in it. Let's try set W 6 and see how that would look. Okay, so everything looks pretty good with number. Maybe it'd be nice if it was shifted back over 1. Let's try set W 5. Okay, I'm liking how that looks. Now let's see if we can get this stuff lined up. I'd kind of like for it to go ahead and show the decimal on the square root portion. So why don't we go ahead and do a fixed up here. So that'll be the fixed format flag. And then let's do a set precision up here as well. Yeah, why don't we do 4 places after the decimal? Remember, when set precision follows fixed, that's the number of places after the decimal. If you don't include fixed, then the number would be the total number of digits that it'll print out. Okay, let's see how that's looking, and then we'll do that last little piece. Okay, it looks pretty good. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, looks like 15 spaces. So let's do our set width. And let's run it one more time and see how that looks. All right, it's looking pretty good. We've got things lined up fairly well. We had an extra space here, but I kind of like the way that looks, where it's a little more centered, and you could continue working with it. Let me just show you one caution. So see how this is ending on the 0 here? If you go back and change this one, this column spacing being different is going to now change the spacing on that second one. So when you're working on these tables, really think about your formatting and your spacing as sort of the very last thing that you want to do, and then start by setting the header and getting the header. So the header would be the thing that's only printing out once. Get that fixed the way you like it. Then get the very first column set the way you like it, and then do the next column, and then do the next column, then do the next column. If you do that last column first, and when you go back and do that first column, it's going to mess up all the other columns. So hopefully this gives you an idea kind of how to get started on this program. Thanks for watching.